Well, thanks a lot, Bob. Seven straight wins for this Nets team. Six of them, they have not had the services of Kevin Durant. Obviously, big-time performances tonight from James Harden, from Bruce Brown. We'll get to that in a moment. But just the game, Sarah. We saw a lot of games that kind of look like this from the Nets earlier in the season, right, where they would let sub-500 teams hang around. Nets didn't have a great defensive effort. And then the Nets would lose those games. But tonight, after they didn't play great D this evening, and Sacramento had taken a late lead, or they would cut it to one, the Nets were able to clamp down, get the stops they needed, and find a way to win.
And that's what it was about in those final closing out minutes, the type of timely stops that they were able to then add into the offense. And I think this team just continues to thrive on their connectivity with one another, the joy you see them playing with for each other, and the type of confidence that they've gained. And does that come from a winning streak like this? Absolutely. But it's the way in which I think everyone feels like they understand their role. They are confident in their role that they need to play. And there was a level of poise throughout the course of this one, especially in those final few minutes.
Yeah, and Bruce Brown tonight. I mean, this guy's been unbelievable. And then he makes you love him more with the shimmying. But, Sarah, you know, this is a team that they needed to find those other pieces around the stars, right? And they're still in that fact-finding mode of who is going to fit in. One guy we know fits in as a rotation piece with this team is Bruce Brown, and he just keeps getting better and better.
He has been tremendous, and you can't say enough things about how critical he's been to the consistency of this lineup. What you knew you were going to get out of him was energy, a tenacity on the defensive end. But my goodness, what he's done offensively. I mean, this night is just a product of how he's been able to utilize the way the defenses are playing him, laying off him a little bit because they think they're going to focus more on some of the stars and the more offensive-minded players on the floor. And he finds his areas, he finds his space, and then he also is able to convert. And I think credit not only goes to him, but also to his teammates, in particular James Harden, because they look for him, they find him. And I think you saw the excitement, whether it's from the bench, from the teammates on the floor, they love the fact that he is being rewarded with a production like we saw here tonight.
And you mentioned Harden. I mean, what we knew about Harden in Houston was he was able to elevate the play of everyone around him. And that's exactly what we're saying here, right? No Kevin Durant, still trying to figure out the other rotation pieces. Okay, he has Kyrie Irving, but no problem. James Harden elevating the play of everyone on the floor.
He's a basketball savant. And when he has the ball in his hands, for him, it's just all about how he's going to read what the defense is doing and manipulate them to try and get the ball in the bucket. We see it so often with his ability to score, but I think it's even more impressive with his passing prowess and how he's been able to get teammates involved. And some of it comes through, yes, making the right reads, but a lot of it, too, I think he just understands what he does for teammates to get that type of confidence, to keep feeding them, to keep finding them, and keep everyone involved, to keep this train rolling.
Well, seven straight wins for Brooklyn. Able to win this one with some fans in the building. All smiles tonight at Barclays Center as we send it back to you guys in the studio.